Pisces friends, and welcome to your April 2020 horoscope, where Pisces, if we take an immediate look at this board, what we can see is how nice and tight this left side of the chart is for you. And when we see this lit up, this tells us it's a time of a personal independence peak. You've got plenty of planets moving over here, so you're still taking actions to move yourself forward, and so many of them are about liberation from old circumstances, right? And many people in the world are experiencing the quarantine time, are experiencing shutdowns with jobs, works, things like that. So you've been put in a position in some way, shape, or form where you literally have to liberate yourself from an old routine, from an old relationship, from something that you were doing, add something to yourself in the downtime so that you can take yourself forward on the other side when all of the energies kind of release up. So I think it's an important month to keep that in mind, because over and over again, as I was going over the horoscope, something that just keeps coming up for you is, yes, I want to tell you with all of these things in the 12th house and all of that going on, rest, take it easy, take care of yourself. And I do think that those things are critically important, but I also feel like in the downtime, in April, Pisces, it's important for you to also move, add to yourself, add to something, begin something, learn something new this month with the support of the energies coming into your third house that can take you forward, that is going to help you advance. It's really a season where I think you get to remember that you get to decide if this is transformation for you or if this is going to be where you decide to stand still. I don't actually believe that there's a wrong answer in any one of those things, as long as what you're doing is standing still trying to advance or moving forward trying to advance. But there just needs to be this sense of intention with the actions that you're taking. And I think that this month in a personal independence peak is really brilliant to help you do that. Now you're going to see that the planets are going to start to move this way, and we're going to move towards the night side of the chart. So you've got personal independence, which is leading to the actions, like you take the push, and then those actions begin to set a brand new foundation for you in your cosmic weatherscape, right? So as you set those foundations, you're doing your learning, your training, your whatever it is that you're doing, then you take them out into the world, and we start to see them very much so be able to materialize in a way that is really beneficial for you. So let's jump in and talk about how to use April and what is going down. First and foremost, we see that we have got Mars and Saturn continuing to travel through this 12th house. They moved into place there really about the 31st together of last month, but they're going to be here as we start this month. Now, Mars is action, energy, movement, assertion. There are things happening. You are in go mode with this particular Mars energy. Now, this can also bring, even in the 12th house place, which is a natural place that you rule, this can even bring a little bit of conflict, right? Maybe it's like you've been, I see this picture of trying to come out of the cocoon. You're trying to be free. Maybe you've had to stretch and you're getting ready to try and wiggle yourself out of one cocooning space and into something where you can fly, something that you can be free. Mars will definitely help you do that. And that takes a little force. That takes a little action to get out of there, right? Have you ever seen a butterfly come out gently or a baby be born and just be like, it was so gentle? None of that happens, right? You got to have some 12th house force. But what is happening is that Saturn is also bringing some grounding to that table. Now, the other thing this makes me think you have good action on is to study, is to research, is to heal, is to take some time to get quiet and pick the next path. Mars in the 12th house, you may be wanting to work on things on your own, but what I would tell you is because this energy is in Aquarius, maybe it's like you're taking a training or you're doing something like that, but you're doing it online with a group and then you get to study by yourself, or you're doing it online where it's a at-home study course or something like that. Because even while this is the 12th house, social things, being social, involving your technology, involving your Aquarian-like behaviors is going to be very important. And the number one thing that Aquarius wants is for you to find your own independence, find your own voice, and then add it to the whole. So you may be working on that quite quietly, but Mars and Saturn are there to help you get serious in order to get that done. On the third, we see Venus moving out of this energy of Taurus, which has been lighting up your third house, and moving into this space of your fourth house. Venus in the fourth house, very first thing I think of is you're wanting to beautify your space, right? And beautify your space in this regard doesn't just have to be the physical home, because it most certainly could be. But I also feel like in some ways, Pisces, maybe your space, your internal emotional space has been freed up in some ways, and you're trying to beautify that. If during the shutdown you've been working from home, you may be finding ways to make home palatable, make it comfortable, make it beautiful, make it something where you feel like you can study and learn Gemini qualities from. You're maybe bringing a little harmony to the conversation in your home or things about home. This is a beautiful energy for that. And yes, even in the shutdown, some people will sell their homes, and Venus will help you get that done for sure.
So also on the fourth here, we're going to have Venus and Neptune coming together. And this is not a great day to make any really super big decisions if you can avoid it. But this is a wonderful, wonderful day to give yourself some grace, pamper yourself a little, just enjoy a little Pisces love, enjoy taking care of yourself, being kind to yourself. Definitely do a nice meditation, maybe even a little ritual, okay? On the fourth, we've got Jupiter and Pluto, who are going to be coming together for the first of their three conjunctions that they will be doing this year. They are both out of retrograde, so full forward motion coming with this one, Pisces. Now, when Jupiter and Pluto are coming together up here in the 11th house, this says find your tribe. When Jupiter and Pluto are in conjunction, you take a leap forward. You haven't done this in 13 years like this. So you take a leap forward, you're driven, and what you start, what you begin here, maybe putting those products online finally, right? Whatever it is, maybe you're investing in technological equipment. This is a yes, a success and a win for you going forward. Now on the 7th, we are going to have a full moon happening in the energy of Libra. The full moon says that something needs to be ended, acknowledged, or adjusted. So we're going to make a shift here in the energy of Libra. One of the questions I have for you is, what's the balance between you and others? Your money and the way that you get money, and maybe ways that you didn't earn. Is there a balance you need to check in on a spouse or a partner and how they're earning money? This could certainly, with the full moon there, be bringing some kind of closure or culmination to something with debt. It could end a relationship. It could definitely do that. But I also think that the moon subconsciously gives you a nice bit of detail as to how to expand this area where you can join collaboratively with people and continue to have it be quite profitable for you. So really dig into that. I think that's a beautiful energy, certainly bringing some different communication to your table. On the 9th, we're going to have Venus moving into her pre-retrograde shadow time. So what this means is she's going to start to slow down. So if things in this area of the home life feel like they're slowing down, like you're taking a little bit more care with things at home, or you're starting to review the area of home, take note of those things, because that's exactly what you're going to work on when Venus goes into the retrograde from May 13th until June 25th. Other things that you could see happening while Venus is moving into this pre-retrograde shadow time that you're making note of is just adjustments you would like to be making to the home zone. And some of that includes internal adjustments as well. Where are you willing, Pisces, to let your heart be a little bit more free? Where are you willing to have a different understanding of what you need emotionally and speak to that? This is definitely a beautiful energy in Gemini quality style for you to speak to your own heart, your own needs, your own necessities down in your home zone as well. Now, on the 11th, we are going to see Mercury move out of the energy of Pisces, where he's been in your sign for a very long time. So lots of thinking, lots of decision making, lots of Mercurying has been going on. And now Mercury is going to move here into the energy of Aries, lighting up your second house all the way until April 27th. Now with Mercury here, along with the sun in your second house, this is conversations, right? You're having conversations, you're decisive, you're being maybe a little bit more quick, maybe a little bit more forceful. There's certainly information coming your way for sure. Around your finances, you're having to make financial decisions, you're having to have financial discussions. This is a beautiful, beautiful energy also to see what talents you have that you can take out into the world and make money with. Now, remember, taking them out in the world doesn't necessarily mean that you're leaving your house. This may be happening in a very technological way, as we saw up here in this Aquarian energy. So keep in mind that your ability to have conversation to make money or to bring something up in a level of value doesn't necessarily have to be one-on-one, person to person. There may be some technology involved in this as well. Now, we have the sun moving on just on the 19th into your third house, so communications get a little bit stronger for you here. The sun brings light, heat, life, and vitality. If you are a writer, if you are a singer, if you are an actress, if you do something where you are speaking or you are studying something, this is a big deal, Pisces. If you're needing to study something new, study something maybe outside of your normal realm of doing things. I keep having this vision of you getting your online product list together, you know, or maybe you've decided, look, just working strategically online won't work for me by myself. I maybe want to learn to work with a company or something like that. You definitely have the benefit of new learning, new training, new speaking happening here in this third house. Now, just on the 22nd, we're going to also have a new moon in this house. So what do you want in this area? What do you want to learn? What do you want to study? What do you want to teach? What do you want to talk about? What kind of conversation would you like to have in your life? This is also an energy I see here too. If you needed to sign a document, if you wanted to buy a house, you needed to re-sign your lease. Plant those seeds of intention here at this new moon for where you'd like to take this very conversational area of your life. Taurus is strong, it is steady, it is dependable. So what you're looking for, what you're asking for to come to manifestation will certainly be helped by this Taurus energy bringing you something sturdy and steady, okay? On the 25th, we're going to see Pluto moving into the energy of a retrograde. Now, Pluto is going to go into retrograde at 24 degrees of Capricorn, come out in October at 22 degrees of Capricorn. So he moves back just nice and slowly. Now, as Pluto is retrograde, and I'm going to do a separate Pluto retrograde video to really jump in there, but what we want to understand about this for you up here is in that 11th house, as Pluto is in the retrograde, it's going over your friends. It's going over your organizational connections. It's going over structures and people who've been in your life maybe for a very long time, or organizations that have been in your life. And it's asking you, where do you need to transform? Where do you need to review this area so that it can transform? It can evolve. You can evolve here. This is an attempt to empower you. Now, this is not something new that you are looking at. It's been in your life. It's been here for a while, and you're being asked to go back over it. Where do you need to reset the structure? Where does some discipline need to come in if you're going to have success, especially in the 11th house at a social level? Now, what you don't want to fall into is this 11th house transiting south node being there where you stay stuck in old behaviors. Instead, you're asking to be detaching from what's been here that's maybe not working. What needs to die off so that it can live in a different way? That's going to be the review and the question of your retrograde. Now, at the same time, we've got Mercury moving out of this energy of Aries, and he's also going to move over here with the rest of the crew into the energy of Taurus. When Mercury moves into the energy of Taurus, first of all, you are picking up on details. You are getting it. It may be slow. Information and training may be coming to you slowly, but you are getting it. You are picking up and absorbing the details, absorbing the information. Because remember, Taurus is strong and sturdy and steady. So here you're having beautiful conversations about things that have durability to them. They have good standing. It's training that will take you far in the years to come, in the months to come. This is a beautiful piece of writing that you're going to put out that may actually make a stamp on history. So what is it that you're doing here, or you're training, or you're learning to do that is ultimately helping you launch and step out? That is a big theme of what's happening this month. You're getting your foundational pieces in place so that as we change and we start to get a little bit more social, you have a product, you have an idea, you have a perspective that you can definitely take out into the world and make it really useful to other people. But right now, let's get those foundations set here in April, okay? All right, Pisces, my favorite little fish, I love you so much. Like this video, comment, share, subscribe, and I look forward to seeing you next month. Bye, my friends.